Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Frisco, Texas. With me, I've got Dallas, Texas' own Maurice Hooker. Maurice, bigger fight announced today for you against Regis Progre. When I spoke to you last time, I think it was in Phoenix in your fight, you said, I want Josh Taylor.
Yes.
You've got Regis. How are you feeling?
I mean, I'm still pumped up about the fight. It's another big fight. But I wanted a world title. I wanted, you know, Josh Taylor. But Regis is a dude. He's a big name. He's one of the best at 140 still. And I'm ready to get it on.
Regis said a quote in the email that we got sent out saying there's some bad blood between you two. What is the bad blood, if you can elaborate a little bit more?
He just talk too much, you know. He talk too much. It's time to shut up and fight. And stop out there talking like a little girl. And let's get in the ring and let's handle like men.
When you seen Regis against Josh Taylor, you obviously watched that fight. What can you take from that fight to help you and basically to go in there against Regis in, was it April 17th?
Yes. I just seen Josh Taylor just the closer in the fight, end of the fight. He was using his size. He would push him around. You know, he was handling him. So I'm going, you know, going to use that a little bit too.
The fact that you are the bigger man, you're going to be, it's at 143 pounds, the fact that you are the bigger man, you're going to use that to your advantage?
Oh, yes. You know, I'm going to use everything I have to my advantage. The height, the size, my arm reach, and my power. You know, it's going to be a good fight. I know I'm the underdog, and I love it. You know, it made me train harder, made me go harder, and I just hope he's ready.
Can you stop Regis? Can you get the stoppage?
No, I'm already thinking about it, yes. I'm not looking past him, but he's a good fighter. But yes, I can. Yes, I'm using my jab, using my reach, and make him desperate to come in with the big looping shots he do.
You beat Regis, you go on. Do you think that your name is up there? So there's three 140-pounders, the two champions, which is Ramirez and Josh, and then yourself, and then hopefully whoever wins that Ramirez, Josh Taylor, you want the winner, right?
Yes, yeah. I mean, I just want to fight the best out there. You know, when I got the phone call, I wanted it. I know I wanted it. You know, I just want the big guy out there. Whoever the fans think is the best, I want.
Is it Maryland? Are you disappointed that? I know that Regis is trained out of Houston. Yeah. You're from Dallas. Are you disappointed a little bit that it's not in Texas somewhere?
Yes, I mean, I wanted it in Texas. You know, I mean, like I said, he do train in Houston. Or I think he went to California now, but
he's
I don't know. Yeah.
He did train in Houston.
Yeah, I mean, he got a good fan base out there. Why not? That'd be nice. We met right there in San Antonio somewhere.
Yeah. Well, I've been to Dallas twice, and I love this city, man. I love this city. I really do. You said that you're the underdog, but of recent time, the last 6 or 7, 8 months, we've seen underdogs prevail. We've seen Andy Ruiz against Joshua. We've seen Tyson Fury last weekend, who was a slight underdog against Wilder. So underdogs can do it.
Oh, yeah, you know, and I'm going to show y'all again, you know, come fight night. You know what I mean? Come on, man. Everybody who know boxing, just look at the size. Look at the style. It's the fight everybody wanted to see. You know, I'm going to use everything I have to advantage.
I want to ask you then, there's two champions in this division, Josh Taylor, Ramirez. When they fight, who wins?
I don't know. That's a toss-up right there. That's a very good fight. That's a good fight. It's a toss-up. I mean, I'm rooting for both of them. You know, both of them are champions for a reason. I'm rooting for both of them.
I mentioned Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder last weekend. Did you watch the fight? Were you surprised like everyone else the way Tyson approached that fight?
Yes. I was very surprised. You know, I was like, why did Tyson Fury gain all that weight? But then come fight night, you can see why. He was hitting and grabbing, using the weight on him. I mean, he's smart. He's a smart guy. I mean, he won. I mean, I'm a fan now. I was being a fan, but now I'm really a fan now. I mean, I think they do a rematch. I do think he'll win again.
Joshua Tyson Fury, who wins? Yeah, Joshua Tyson Fury.
That's a good one. I'm going to have to go with Anthony Joshua because he's younger. Just because. No, is he 30? What, 30?
He's 30. Tyson's 31, so there's only a year between them.
No, I don't know. That's a toss-up. I thought he was a little older. That's a good fight. And best man win.
Fingers crossed I'm going to be in Maryland on April 17th. What can we expect from you going into this fight? I mean, it's a tough name. Regis comes to fight. Can we expect a war from you?
Oh, yes. I mean, a good, smart war, though. Not just any kind of war. I'm going to be smart. I'm going to use my skills and show everybody that I can box.
Mo, as always, thanks for this 5-0 TV, brother. And hopefully I'll see you on April 17th.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.